Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to create a Gantt chart in Excel using a template that is similar to Microsoft Project. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. I've included a link below in the description to this page right here on Microsoft's website. You may need to sign into your Microsoft account first in order to follow along with these instructions. So if you haven't done that, go ahead and do that. If you don't have a Microsoft account, you can create a free one and then come back to this page. So as you can see, this is the Gantt Project Planner. And if I look over here on the right, this looks very similar to what I would see in Microsoft Project. But this is a free version if you already own Microsoft Excel or if you plan on using the free version of Microsoft Excel. So you have two options over here. You can either download the template to use on the desktop version of Microsoft Excel, or you can come over here and open the template in your browser. So let's click on that option. And now you can see that the Gantt chart template has been opened inside of Microsoft Excel. So let's explore this a little bit. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. If I look over here to the left, I can see some generic activities have been entered. And so for each activity in here, I can see that I have a plan start, a plan duration, an actual start, an actual duration, and a percent complete. Now, what do each of these numbers mean? Well, if you look over here, you can see that this is a generic title right here for periods. And this is up to you to decide if you want your time periods to be in hours or days or weeks or months, depending on how big your project is. So let's play around with a few of these numbers and see what happens. So on this first activity, I have a planned start and an actual start that coincide with each other. So I actually am starting this task on the day that I plan to start it on. I had planned for 5 days of the duration of it, but it actually only took 4 days. And right now I'm only at a 25% completion rate. So let's think about what that means. It means I have done one of these 4 actual days of work. And because of that, this will be shaded dark purple because this means percent actually complete. So if I go over here to my percent complete and I make that 50, you can see that I now have 2 days completed of my actual duration because I'm 50% complete. So if I change this to 75, I will now see that it's 3. And if I change this to 100, all 4 days have now been color coded. And I will see that this task is actually finished just by quickly looking at this graph over here. Now let's look at activity 5 over here. I plan to start it on the same time period. I thought it was going to take 2 days, but it actually took 8. And I have this at an 85% complete. So let's see what these color codes mean up here. So I can see that of these 8 time periods that I have color coded right here, 2 of them, being these 2 days right here that I had planned on, are my percent complete. But what are these 3 orange ones? I'm going to scroll to the right a little bit. And you can see that these are my percent complete beyond my plan. And then I have some actual complete right here that I have not gotten to yet. But if I were to change this to 90, you can see that I've now filled in another dark orange that is my percent complete up here beyond my plan. And if I took this down to 50, you'll be able to see that I am only half done and I have half my task to go, but right here it is in the actual beyond the plan. So I know that my graph is being changed based on what percent I have done and how long my project is actually taking. So just keep those two variables in mind. So one final thing you can do on this spreadsheet is change this period highlight right here. Right now this is set to 1, but say I were to come here and scroll down and pick 10. You can see that period 10 has now been highlighted. And if I scroll down, I just have changed the background to this beigeish color so I can just get a quick visual of what's happening on period 10, whether that's hour 10, day 10, month 10. And if I change that again to say 15, now this column is being highlighted for a quick visual as to what is going on that week. So hopefully this gives you a good introduction to one template that you can use inside of Microsoft Excel that acts like Microsoft Project. There are a lot of other templates out there. If you just Google Microsoft Excel Gantt chart, you will be able to find lots of different kinds of templates that you can use inside of Microsoft Excel. And maybe one of those other ones will meet your needs more than this one does. But I just wanted to show you the general idea that there are templates that are out there that you are able to use and customize inside Microsoft Excel to allow Microsoft Excel to sort of act like Microsoft Project. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.